ಅವರು ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮೀಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲವು ಮೀಡಿಯಾಗಳು ಬಹಳ ತುಂಬಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇ ಏನು ಇಲ್ಲದೇ ಇರುವ ತರ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಬಿಂಬವನ್ನು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಬಹುದು ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ಅಜೆಂಡಾ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಬಹುಜನ ಅವರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅದೇ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದು ಹೇಗೆ ನಾವು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು, ಹೇಗೆ ನಾವು ಈಗ ನಾನೊಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್. ಒಪ್ತೀರಾ? ಪ್ರತಿ ಒಂದು ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಹೌಸು ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ. ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ನಡೆಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಇರ್ತವೆ, ಹೌದಲ್ಲ? ಮುಂದೆ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇಂಟೆಲೆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ಸ್ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಕಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅವ್ರು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಈಗ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಬೈ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ಸ್. ಅವರು ಕೆಲವರು ಸ್ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರು ಸ್ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅವರು ಬೇಕು, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇವರು ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಅಜೆಂಡಾ ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕೋ ಅದೇ ಅಜೆಂಡಾ ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಕೆಲವು ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ಗಳಾಗಿ ಕೆಲವು ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಹೌಸಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ಅದು ಬಹಳ ಬ್ಲೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೂಡ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಯಾವುದು ನಮಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಇದು ಬೇಕಿಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಬ್ಲೇಟೆಂಟ್. ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಎರಡು ವಿಷಯ ನಮಗೀಗ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಒಂದು, ದಿ ರೈಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ. ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಡೆಮೋಕ್ರೆಟಿಕ್. ನನ್ನ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಟ್ವಿಟರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈಗ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಇವರಿಗೆ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಫೋರಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಕೆಲವು ವಿಷಯಗಳು ನಾವು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿ. ನಾನು ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಕೆಲವು ನೀವು ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಬಹಳ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮೀಡಿಯಾಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಂಟ್ ಇದೆ. ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿಗಳು ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಅಜೆಂಡಾ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಂಟ್ ಇದೆ. ಅದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಂಟ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕೋ ಅದು ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಹೇಗಿದೆ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಮೀಡಿಯಾವೂ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಇವತ್ತು ನನಗೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಡಬಲ್ ಟು ಪೇ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್. ದೇ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್, ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ದೆಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ ಈ ತರ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೇಡ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಡಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ನನಗೆ ಈ ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್, ಈ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್, ಈ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರೈಮ್ ಇದೆ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅದು ಅವ್ರು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಆ ವಿಷಯ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಆಗಬಹುದು. ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬಹಳ ರೇಷನಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದರೆ, ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಹೌಸಸ್ ಇವತ್ತು ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಥರ್ಮಾಮೀಟರ್ ತರ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವತ್ತೇನು ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇವತ್ತೇನು ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇವತ್ತು ಇವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಿರುವ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಆ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇಂದ ಒಂದು 4-5 ಪ್ಯಾಸೇಜ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಆಂಗಲ್ ಇಂದ ನೋಡಿದರೆ ನಾವು ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೂ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ಈ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಎ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್, ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಗಾಂಧಿ ನೋ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಚ್ ಸಾಲ್ವರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ. ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಅದು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಕೊಡುವಾಗ ನೋಡಿದಿರಾ, ಅವ್ರು ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗುವ ಟೈಮ್, ಅವರು ಮುಂದೆ ಮಾತಾಡುವರು, ಅವ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೀಳುವ ಲೈಟು, ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿರುವ ಡ್ರೆಸ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಟ್ಲರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ. ಗೋಬಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್. ಇಂಥವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಅವ್ರು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ದಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ರೇಪ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪೆಂಡ್, ಐ ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗೈಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೇಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪೆಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಒಬ್ಬರೊಬ್ಬರು ಇಂಥ ವಿಷಯಕ್ಕೆ ಫೋರ್ ವಾರ್ನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಇವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಇವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ನಾವು ಮಾತ್ರ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಫೋರ್ ವಾರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂ, ಹೌ ಟು ಎಂಗೇಜ್, ಕನ್ನನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್. ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ, ನೋ ಹೌ ವಿ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಸೋ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ವೆಹೆಮೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ. ಸೊ ಆ ಒಂದು ಒಬ್ಬ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ನನ್ ಗೋಪಿನಾಥನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್, ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಫೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಬಹಳ ಜನ. ಈಗ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ದಾರಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಅದು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೋದು, ಆವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆರಾ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಒಂದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿ ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡಬಹುದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೀಗೆ ಅಂತ, ಬಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಏನ್ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಇದು ಉತ್ತರ ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ.
Just add on to what sir said, it's not just a matter of one institution, media. So when I resigned, I gave a statement that when institutions fail, individuals have to stand up. Because why are saying, people are asking, as an individual, one person, what difference would you make to Kashmir policy? You know, you resign, what is going to happen? So I said, what as an individual can I do? I am seeing that all the institutions are failing. So when the institutions are failing, as an individual, all I can do is I stand up and say something is wrong. That's all I can do. But later I realized that actually institutions are individuals. What is media? He limited it to institutions. I slightly make, right now there is a vilification going on against Ashok Lavasa, sir. He's the election commissioner. What is it? He's not an individual. He's an institution. What is that institution? Election commission. Okay, he's an election commissioner appointed by this very same government. He was a finance secretary in the same government. But after, during this election, because he took a couple of stands, okay, he did not even dissent with the government. He dissented with the other two election commissioners in the election commission. Because he did that, immediately after that July, there have been cases, you know, there have been, you know, raids and stuff against, targeted against his wife, his sister, his son, you know, trying to find something against his daughter, everybody in the family. And if we don't stand with him, then in another 6 months we would say election commission is also gone. He's trying to fight. He's the institution. Because institutions are also individuals. And they need our support. When we don't provide that support, it's very difficult to be a TN session, and you know, we're all normal people. When that question comes of your sister and your wife and your daughter and your son becomes an issue, then you don't think about becoming a martyr for the country. It becomes, still is fighting. But nobody is, at least when a complaint comes, you should know why is that. You should not make your, that's why it is, democracy is a difficult project. And authoritarianism, why people move to authoritarianism or fascism is because it's easy. An authoritarianism asks only one thing from its citizen. What is that? Loyalty. Only one thing. Loyalty. Democracy requires that the people know things. People question things. People discuss things. People protest. Get out on the streets. It's such a difficult thing to be a citizen in a democracy. It's so much of burden. Imagine in an authoritarianism, it's just, you are my boss, I bow to you, whatever you do is in my favor, I know that. He only asks one thing, if somebody questions me, you support me. That's it. So democracy is also is a very difficult part. But I see all these institutions as a players in a stadium. Okay? Judiciary, media, politicians, everybody. And we are all in the gallery. Right now, there is only one side of the gallery which is filled. Okay? The other side is vacant. And that one side is only cheering. They are only saying, you know, well done, well done, well done. So all the shots are being played to that side. Because we left. Like we left many of the WhatsApp groups. Many of us would have left WhatsApp groups. Yes. Feeling that fake news, this thing, there is no point talking. You did not leave the WhatsApp group. You left that stadium. You left the 200 people in that WhatsApp group in the, at the mercy of those 5 people in those people who are writing. Because 5 people put those messages, 10 people gives a thumbs up, and you feel this whole group is gone. We all feel that. And we immediately think, let's get out of this group. Who will? Because you think, who will put the effort? Why is it I should put effort? Because they have ready-made content. You have to search for everything, then this thing, then they will give another stupid content, then you find another, you know, then, man, this is crazy. We all do. But because, that is because you get out, and that's why I call people who leave WhatsApp groups as the anti-national. People who leave WhatsApp groups are the real anti-national. Anti-national. Not rational, I say Deshdrohi. No, I'm just saying my view. I definitely like your view also. But I'm just saying they are Deshdrohi in a way. You are putting your mental peace or your comfort above the nation. Because if you had actually bothered about nation, you would have taken that pain to counter that person in that. You don't need to do anything. Just counter in that WhatsApp group. What is the source? If it is somebody respectful, you don't want to counter in the group. It's a many family groups, you know, it's difficult to tell them, because you're wrong. Then you go to his private message and say, at least, you know, chacha, mama, whatever is that, please, where is the source? You have to question that. It's a simple thing. So whoever has left, the first patriotic act is to get back in those WhatsApp groups. The first and most important one. Because this country has been won and lost on WhatsApp groups now. There are 360,000 WhatsApp groups prepared, and that is what is controlling the messages. And you're all part of that, you left. Because we left that stadium. That one side, there is nobody. Important to first get into that gallery. It's like an India-Pakistan match. Okay? Imagine it's happening in Karachi. Okay? The full majority would be from the Pakistan. But then you will see 150 people from India shouting at the top of their voice to let those players know that we are there for you. It's important to be those 150 people. It's important to get into that stadium. It's important to get into that stadium and say we are there for you. So there are a lot of people fighting for you and me in the system. A lot of people. And that's why we have to shout. We have to clear. So any institution, when you say any institutions, you immediately, I was telling, you have to, if there is something, judgment is wrong, you feel, some 10 people have to write against that judgment. Because that puts a narrative, that puts actually something that, okay, that's wrong. Media, you think, one media would say this, slowly things would change. Because as sir said, it's ultimately they have to make money. And the money is from viewership. And then maybe somebody would also understand. I was just thinking, who are the kind of people who spend? Okay? Because people, many of times they go by viewership, TRP. They are not being smart. If I have to advertise, I will not advertise in a channel which has the highest TRP. Okay? I would rather advertise in a channel which has a TRP, whose viewers are actually going to spend. Because ultimately it's not my reach that is important, it's actually the reach getting converted into the purchase. That conversion is important. But we don't think that. Slowly people would make that connections also. Who are the people who are going to spend? And it's their opinion which is going to matter. So these things also will change. They will also realize what is good for the country is also good for the business and is also good for us. It's never the case, something which is bad for the country is never good for the business. In the short term it might look like that. But not in the long run. And yesterday Rahul Bajaj asked this question. Somebody had to, because I was in Dadra Nagar Haveli. I was holding not just collector charge. I was GST commissioner, MD of a DISCOM, pollution, a labor commissioner, etc., etc. And it is a small industrial area with a 1 lakh crore turnover, 4,000 industries. And you would see businessmen coming and saying, "What is happening? What is happening?" And they know what is. They really lost it. They feel that. Something the country is going through is very difficult phase. But they can't keep up. But somebody will speak up. If I had not resigned, Sasikanth would have resigned first. If he had not, somebody else would have. Somebody else would have. Because that was the kind of condition. Our country has a lot of contradictions. These contradictions was the reason why emergency did not succeed. These contradictions will be the reason why none of those projects will succeed. It is not going to succeed. But I have a issue with, I have a difference of opinion with calling it fascism. Because I feel they are really dumb people. I honestly feel so. I feel the government, I'm not talking about the system, okay, the project and 100, the government is seriously dumb. They really don't know what is it that they are doing. They just do, five people would sit, just imagine. I am not worried about the chief, the prime minister who does not know that radar can pierce through the cloud. But I am worried about that Indian Air Force chief who does not have the, to correct him at that point of time. Imagine this was some other real war situation and the prime minister is making such a stupid decision. And the people who are sitting and let's say everybody is sitting, yes, you are correct. And imagine what the position our country would have been in. I am worried. When our top bureaucrats are unable to say, "Boss, you are being stupid." And they are being stupid almost on a daily basis. And we are unable to call that out. Why is it important to say they are stupid? It's because for a common person, if you go to a village and tell them they are fascists, suddenly they are scared. They feel like this is some huge project. What do we do? Tell them they are bevkoof. Do thappad laga do, side laga. Immediately they respond with kaha pe thappad lagana. The response changes. It's after my experience. after talking, because the village responds, though, and I call them, it's like a bevkoof with a hatta katta, and he also does a lot of damage. Imagine a stupid fellow, really dumb fellow, he has heavy built muscle, and let's say there are two people like that. Okay, now imagine there are two people like that. Imagine the amount of havoc he can create here. He'll just run here, half people would go there, he'll run there. Ultimately, people would realize they have to be tied, beaten up and kept in some place there. Because that's an easy thing for people to understand. There are two people who are running amok. And they are really dumb. They have to be somehow, you know, kahin pe usko rakhna padega. For our own country, for our own safety. And we have to do that. I agree. We have to differentiate between what we want to communicate, what translates into action, and what is the ideology behind it. These are two different things. So these aspects have to be, maybe we'll come to a later stage at that point of time.
Point what Kannan is making, the propaganda, the communication of how to fight this, we might understand what it is, but how do we fight it? We don't have to fight by giving all these theories. We need to fight in a way that it delivers an outcome for us. You know, answering your question, you know, you also said, see, there has been a very authoritarian government. We have faced this during Indira Gandhi's period. Everybody knows emergency. But never there was a period where people were pitted against people. Now, that is a classic thing of fascism. You know, how do you separate authoritarianism from this? This angle is when people are pitted against people. Today, if you have an issue and you go and stand on the road, you know, like say for talking about Ayodhya, I'm sure many of you might not express, but it will be there in your mind. Will the majority not, you know, do something to us? You know, earlier you were afraid of the state. Now you are also afraid of the majority. What might these guys do? If somebody sits when the national anthem is there, even though they have a different point of view, now they have to stand up. Some 10 fellows will come and ask you, hey. That is the danger of this system. So this system has to be fought in a very intelligent way. And also, as Kannan is saying, the communication of how we bring public opinion needs to be thought about also. Okay, it can't be very complex, and because it revolves on emotions. How that propaganda runs on emotions. Chor, ye, daku, ye. So somehow when you express also, you have to express in a way that public opinion is touched in the right sense. I think that would help.
Sorry, one question I forgot to answer.
Yeah, you
should explain that. A long question. But I have a slight point. One of Gandhi also. The main bane that we have of the nation is that people who hate Gandhi read Gandhi. People who love Gandhi has no clue what who Gandhi is. Who don't know at all. You know, the best government is the one which governs the least. Whose statement is it? Gandhi. That's what. This was his statement. Swadeshi, everybody knows. There can never be an independence without voluntary interdependence between nation states. Whose statement was it? Gandhi. What was he talking about? Swadeshi, everybody knows. But he's saying there cannot be a Swadeshi or independence, you know, independence of a nation state without voluntary interdependence. What is voluntary interdependence? The trade, the communication that we're having. What is that? See, we don't know about Gandhi. We just know something he is. And we don't read. We don't read anything about him. We don't talk about anything about him. I try to put every day of something on Gandhi on Twitter. You know, something that... How many of you know Gandhi advocated violence? Okay. His statement is, if you have to choose between cowardice and violence, choose violence. But if you have a choice between violence and non-violence, choose non-violence. Imagine, We just talk, he's an ahimsa, he doesn't know anything. He's saying, don't be a coward. If it is a choice between being a coward and violence, you choose non-violence. But non-violence is a much bigger tool to fight anything than violence. And so you are being much braver by choosing non-violence. So we don't read, we don't understand Gandhi. It's not about the government. Government also understands this thing very clear. Just like it knows electricity goes and it comes back, we'll be happy. So take something away, it can be given. So it knows that people would be happy if you give anything package around Gandhi. So that is, how many of you have seen your note, 500 rupees note or 100 rupees note? Have you seen? There is two, and there is a Swachh Bharat Abhiyan written. Imagine a government scheme printed on a currency note. Never been in this country. Even another time, let's say a government comes, they want to change the name to Nirmal Bharat Abhiyan, then they'll change all these notes again. You know, means, what is it? Every note has this. Yeah, just to answer your question about argument, I have a very simple point. Hate the ideology, hate the people who are spewing that ideology, but don't hate the people. Okay? Whoever be it, they are our own fellow citizens. We are going to stay together in this country, irrespective of the differences of our ideology, and we are going to stay together, and we are going to progress together. Never, if they keep hating you, I was just writing on Twitter this thing, if they keep hating you as anti-national, and you keep dismissing them as trolls, when will the conversation happen? The biggest success of a regime is that the conversation or the communication has been broken down. The country has been very neatly divided, X and Y. And you know what X believes and X wants. You just need to provide that. Because X will never talk to Y. And Y will never talk to X. This has been very clearly done. It is not the anything else. It's just now the initiative has to be taken to talk to the people who don't agree with us. Initiative has to be taken to... Because this is the biggest success, this communication break, you know, breakdown. They are not very evil people. The people, common person, the person who yesterday trended Mohammed Balatkari Nikla on Twitter. Many of them were just taken over by the fact that some of the online magazines only mentioned that Mohammed Pasha or Mohammed Arif's name. They did not mention the other three Hindu names in that thing. They did not mention at all. Means they are just mentioned as others. In a gang rape, there is only one, the others are others, three Hindu names are others. And then they ran this, and a lot of people are so upset with what happened with that girl. They were really angry. And when angry, and then they are told that it's only one community which does this crime, and it's repeatedly told this is the same community which does this crime, they feel to heck with them. This, everybody would do that, they'll see that, okay, you know, just that's it, enough. Don't hate them for that. Try to understand how did they reach that position of hating. When you understand that, because they know now the communication is happening. That's why we have to talk. They will give you name, call you names. Name calling. Anti-national, Deshdrohi, Pakistan. I was called a Pakistani agent. Of course, sir was also called a Pakistani agent. Vatican
Implant.
Oh, okay.
You were shaking hands with the Bishop of Bangalore. That photo was downloaded and it was called Vatican Implant. Implant of Vatican. It can go to any extent.
Yeah, mine was very different because when I did that, some new major newspaper in Pakistan, they gave a front page news of an IAS civil servant resigning in for Kashmir and stuff like that. And then one minister of Pakistan, he wrote on Twitter that just like Kannan, every civil servant of India should resign. Okay? I think he was the only person who heard. So this fellow wrote that. And everybody asked me, how do you feel like being a Pakistani agent?
You're wearing a green shirt. Of course you're a
Yeah, so I'm wearing a green shirt too. Man. Right away from here to jail. So then this happened. When this happened, about the Pakistani agent part repeatedly coming. Funnily, I was asking that, you know, imagine the government is so incompetent,
that a Pakistani agent inside the government had to get out on his own. You know, they couldn't even find me till I was there for 7 days. After that, I'm saying, okay, I want to go now. You are too, you know, dumb enough to work for. So that is the kind of, but thing is, name calling. Name calling is, you have to learn to ignore this. In any conversation with another person on Twitter or Facebook or anything, there will always be a component of name calling, which will call you anti-national. If the things I am saying would have been told by a Muslim, he would have been immediately termed the terrorist. Atangwadi. Yesterday I was having a talk in one of the university alumni thing, and the professor, the person who was organizing is saying, Kannan, please don't speak anything anti-establishment. I said, why did you call me? If you don't want to. But then I understood he was not the one who called me, the young fellow who wanted to say all these things that I wanted to say, he called me. And since he is a Muslim, he can't say the things that I want to say. So he effectively wanted me to say the things that he wanted to say. So I was telling him, don't worry, we'll make an India where you and me can say the same things. We don't have to worry about, you know, who is saying what. And we'll make it, I'm very sure. When this happened, name-calling part, learn to ignore the name-calling part. The next would be character assassination. Character assassination could be on anything, your motive, like Vatican implant. So you have an ulterior motive of being propagating Christianity or something like that. Or, you know, for me, mine was that I have an ulterior motive of becoming a politician. Or I was running away from some big corruption charges, and that is why I resigned. So assigning motives. Assigning motives could also be on the rape part. Many a times, okay, this is a very wrong time to come to that part, but I'll just say, since many of you are here, yesterday, after the incident, my wife was asking, Kannan, do you harass women? Okay, so she asked me, Kannan, do you harass women? So I said, no. Why, you know, that's like very insulting question. So I said, why? So she said, every woman I know have been harassed. But every man I know is innocent. How can that be? Means, that's not possible, right? Every woman thinks that every person around is his, her son, or every man also. My brother, my son, my father, they won't do this. We're all good people. But then who is doing this? People who are doing this also is somebody's brother, son, father, etc. But we don't go to our home and ask this question. So yesterday I just wanted to come to that part. Probably if you can go and ask, are you a harasser to your husband, to your daughter, son, to your father, or to my brother, if I'm able to do that, just to check. And so she was telling, I just wanted to be sure. Because there are so many of them, I'm not sure whether you are or not. Coming back to the point, this character assassination part happens. Then third is, what about? They'll immediately come on Kashmiri Pandit. I was talking about Kashmir, so everybody said, what happened to Kashmiri Pandit? Or Sikh, Sabrimala issue, 3-4 things they would say. That's called where were you when or what about tree. Or Hindi mein tab aap kaha the. Tab aap kaha the. Once you understand this, I started asking, like, okay, I might have resigned in whatever, I wouldn't have been in a nursery also, but whatever be that, I resigned from there, let's assume, when Kashmiri Pandit issue had happened. But how could I resign than the other things? I can only resign once. There are 3-4 things that you want me to resign from. So how do you then respond? Then I understood the only person, the people who are all asking these questions are the real hypocrites. Because they have not taken a stand on anything. Anything. The only person who can answer to this where were you when question is a person who has never done anything in his life. Tab aap kaha the? Kashmiri Pandit ke time kaha the? Tab bhi main kuch nahi kar raha. सिखों के साथ हो रहा था तब आप कहाँ थे तभी मैं घर पे था कुछ नहीं कर रहा था आप गुजरात में व्हाट आर यू डूइंग देन आल्सो आई वाज नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग द ओनली पर्सन हु कैन आंसर कंसिस्टेंटली ऑन दिस व्हाट अबाउट एवरीथिंग इज अ पर्सन हु हैज नेवर डन एनीथिंग बिकॉज़ द मोमेंट यू टेक अ स्टैंड ऑन एनीथिंग दैट थिंग इज ओवर यू आर नो मोर एबल टू टेक स्टैंड सिमिलर स्टैंड अगेन एंड अगेन सो दिस हैज टू बी क्लियर सो दीज आर कॉल्ड हायरार्की ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स And at the topmost comes the refutation at the central point, refuting the central point, the point which that you want to refute. Every day I engage in a conversation and they start with Maa Behan Ke Gaali and they end with thank you for being humble or thank you for having this conversation. It starts every day. Every day I do that, every day it comes down to that. Because I do not want to break down the conversation with my own fellow citizens.